You don't have to call me darling, darling. You never Waylon Jennings, and you don't have to call me Charlie Brown.
Hello, Lincoln. PTV2 here, and we have an amazing show for you today. I'm Matt, the anchor for today's show, bringing the latest and greatest in Red Storm news. On today's show, we will be discussing our Autism Awareness Week, the Lincoln Ice Cream Fundraiser, and so much more. So sit tight, and we'll be right back after this special song going out to Mr. Miller.
Here at PTV2, we appreciate all the feedback that everyone here at Lincoln provides for us. Remember, you can just do this with the click of a button. Just go to ljhdigitalstorm.com and click the button titled Contact Us.
This is Lincoln's Autism Awareness Week. Autism awareness items will be on sale in the cafeteria. Hopefully you wore blue for our spirit assembly today. The spirit stick will be awarded by grade rather than team.
Eighth grade is definitely going to win.
Yeah, right. You can try, but I think seventh grade's got this in the bag.
Champ, I love ice cream so much.
Yeah, me too.
What if I told you that we would have a chance to have ice cream in our classes?
Are you serious?
Yeah, I'm serious.
Well, I want that. Well, if you're interested, watch this.
Today is your last chance to order your ice cream. Remember, proceeds will go towards Blessings in a Backpack, which helps students at your school. You can still order your ice cream today, and it will still be served to you during max time on Monday.
One scoop of ice cream will cost $2.
You may buy more than one scoop, but it will cost extra, and thank you for helping support the program.
If you have questions, please contact Sydney Weir, Audie Plotho, Cece Listenberger, or Kyle Heckman.
I'm definitely down for this.
Me too. I love Mooney's ice cream.
Same here.
With the end of the year approaching faster than ever, and by the way, just in case you're counting, there are only 27 days left of the school year, we need to plan on turning our library books in soon. Make sure that you get those in so that before Mrs. Day can close up and doesn't have to track you down.
Last Thursday, many of our FFA students competed in the annual District 2 Livestock Judging Contest. Our school's teams placed 6th and 7th at the event, which isn't too bad considering they left the competition early to get students back to the school for other events. It was also these students' first time at the livestock judging competition, and they did great.
For today's birthdays, we have Michael Boyd, and on Saturday, it will be Taylor Landry's birthday. Happy birthday from everyone here at PTV2.
Now it's time to talk about our most incredible Red Storm sports, weather, and lunch. What's up, Braden?
Not a lot is happening, but before I start with our sports and lunch today, I'd like to give a shout out to our sponsor, Oliver Ford, where you get the best deals. Attention all interested in tennis. We have an opportunity for you. The Plymouth Tennis Club is having sign-ups. People 11 and up can sign up by contacting Michael Delp and getting a paper or virtual form. If you're interested in this opportunity, contact Michael Delp at the high school. Even if you sign up online, you will still have to submit payments at sign-ups or to Michael Delp. Checks will need to be made out to Plymouth Tennis Club. Sign-ups are Monday, May 4th and Tuesday, May 5th from 4 to 7 p.m. at this course in Centennial Park. There was a girls' golf match last night, but we do not have results in yet. We will try to have the stats in on Monday's show. For Monday's lunch, we will be having cool walking tacos, way to go salsa, fresh off the cob corn, some fruit, and some of the best cow milk you can find at home. Enjoy, Lincoln! Taking a look out the weather window, today is going to be a high of 57 and a low of 35. And there's going to be some rain on Saturday, but the rest of the week is going to be cloudy and a little bit of sun peeking out. Again, a big thanks to our sponsor, Oliver Ford, where the best cars are at the Ford. Now back to our anchors, Clay and Champ. What's up, guys?
Thanks, Braden.
Did you know that an average human only uses 10% of their brain?
No, I didn't.
In fact, recently, a study was published by the Daily Mail debunking the world's top 50 myths.
That sounds exciting. Let's take a look.
I learned this morning that many popular modern-day beliefs are actually misconceptions. This has been uncovered by Ripley's Believe It or Not, and we are about to debunk some of these so-called facts that we all think are true. Carson, you got the first one.
All right, yep. Did you know that Mount Everest is not the tallest mountain?
What?
Did you know that? No. It is the highest altitude, but the tallest mountain is actually Mauna Kea in Hawaii.
From the base to the
yes,
top.
Yes, right.
It's under the sea. Okay, all right.
Well, did you know that vitamin C apparently does not treat a cold? It can help boost your immune system, but it does not treat an existing cold. So if you have a cold and you're boosting up on vitamin C, it's not going to do you much
good. I feel like that works. I always take vitamin C.
Yeah.
Right there.
Oh.
Yeah, sorry.
Well, but it does help boost the immune system.
Okay.
So for preventing a cold.
Okay. You know the forbidden fruit in the Bible that Eve hands to Adam?
Apple? Yeah.
What kind of fruit was it?
Apple.
Yeah, apple.
It was not an apple.
Why dare you?
No. Yeah, exactly. Turns out the Bible mentions a fruit picked from a tree, but never explicitly says it's an apple.
But there's a picture it's an apple.
Well, yeah. those weren't pictures.
Yeah.
It's a photo.
It's a photo.
Yeah. Carson's going to go back to his big picture
they didn't say
Bible.
It wasn't an apple.
Exactly.
Yeah. Could have been a nectarine. It could have been an apple. Could have been a kiwi.
Here's a common one. Did you know that the direction in which your toilet flushes,
right,
is not caused by your location on the globe? For example, if you're north or south of the equator.
Really?
Right.
Do people think that's true? That
Yes. People say go to Australia and it spins in the other direction.
Yes. Yeah.
You know why it does?
Why? Oh.
Because the jets are pointing in the other direction. That's why.
Oh my gosh.
Mm-hmm.
Well, here's one. Did you know the Great Wall of China cannot be seen from space?
I don't know about this one.
You know, it's only be seen if you're orbiting very close and you got a zoom lens, but you cannot see it from space with the naked eye.
It's so funny because I would have sworn I've seen a picture of the Great Wall from space, but I guess I never
have. Taken through a zoom lens.
Right. By the way, coffee beans are from seeds. Coffee is from seeds, right?
Oh, not from beans.
Okay. All right. Yeah. Well, we're all going to be popular at parties with these little factoids now. All right, that's what's trending today.
Whoa, I never knew those myths weren't true.
Neither did I. So let's review today's show.
Today is the last day to buy ice cream for blessings in a backpack.
Today is our spirit assembly.
Remember to sign up for tennis.
And again, a big thanks to our sponsor, Oliver Ford. When you shop here, you're a family.
Darling, you never even call me by my name. You don't have to call me Waylon Jennings.